So, now that we have the intake manifold off of the motor, and we have the exhaust manifold, which is sitting over there, off the motor, we can now check out the exhaust and intake manifold gasket. There's your intake for the four pistons. There's your exhaust for the four pistons. Now, if you look here, they didn't even put the same bolts back in. See, these are factory bolts. All right. That one's not. That one's not. That one's not. That one's not. So, let me show you the difference between a factory bolt that's designed to hold an intake and exhaust manifold onto the gasket and then onto the motor block. So the intake and the exhaust manifolds clamp onto this gasket, and then these bolts and these washers sandwich everything together and make sure that you get a really nice tight seal. Well, here is the factory nut that goes with the factory bolt. You can tell it's pretty old, you know, 1995. But you can see how it's like concave. It's kind of like a little teepee. So that way, when this thing goes on here, like so, and you torque that bolt down, this big, beefy washer doesn't begin to flex. Because this area gets hot when you run it, and then it gets cold when you turn it off. Hot, cold, hot, cold, hot, cold, hot, cold. Vehicle's on, vehicle's off. All right? So these big, beefy washers are made to bite down on this gasket and the exhaust manifolds and hold everything together to make sure that you don't get any leaks and any blow-by, which will then burn everything up. Well, so this is, like I said, this is the factory Jeep bolt designed, engineered to do its job right. The Yahoos at All Pro Tune decided to, I guess, maybe lose a bolt or mix match bolts or whatever. I have no idea. But here you have, obviously, a completely different bolt. Look at this washer. This washer, one, is skinnier. Two, you can see how it's been deformed. One, it's deformed because it's a lot skinnier than this beefy washer right here. That beefy washer is concave. This one's flat. It's obviously made out of a weaker metal, too. And it's a thinner metal. Plus, when it heats up and cools down, heats up and cools down, it stresses that metal, and then the washer begins to bend. When the washer begins to bend, the bolt begins to get loose. When the bolt begins to get loose, this manifold doesn't hold onto the gasket, and then you start to burn up the gasket. Not only do they have one crappy washer on there, they have two crappy washers on there, which have been deformed. Then they have a lock washer on there, which you can tell usually lock washers, you know, one side is higher than the other. That way they can squeeze down like kind of like a spring and hold everything together. Well, hot, cold, hot, cold, hot, cold stresses the metal. This lock washer is virtually flat. So that lock washer isn't holding this bolt on, so this bolt gets loose and then you start to get blow by. Ultimately, what happens is you burn the goddamn exhaust gasket up, exhaust manifold gasket up. So obviously that's not the right bolt. Now let's look at where we have the burnout at. That's a factory bolt, that's a factory bolt, that's a factory bolt. That's not, that's not, that's not. And this one was just completely missing. While I was overseas, a buddy of mine found a bolt and put it back on just to make sure that all the bolts were there. He did me a solid, but and this was just a temporary fix. But he did help out, because All Pro Tune just didn't even put a bolt on. It was just missing. It was just AWOL. So, wrong bolt, wrong bolt, wrong bolt. So right up in here, on this top level, is where the wrong bolts are. Well, let's flip this gasket over to the other side. That's the top part. See how this rubbery paper gasket has just been completely burnt off right here at the top? Well, that's where the bad bolts are. The bolts that are on the bottom that are proper gasket's good. Now right here, all right, right here, this bolt right here, this is on the front of the motor, closest to the radiator, all right? This one was completely missing. That's the one that my buddy put in. If you look right here, because that bolt was missing, the gasket was just starting to go. My buddy got that bolt, put it in, helped it last a little bit longer. But this part right here, with these incorrect warping bolts and washers that are getting loose, allowed all those hot exhaust gases to basically jump out and burn this gasket up. We just did this maybe a little bit over a year ago. We had a brand new motor installed, brand new exhaust gaskets, seals, even a brand new exhaust manifold, because our old manifold from 1995 had cracked. So we put in a whole new exhaust manifold. And they can't even use the right bolts. So, we're putting in a brand new motor, but they're using shot vacuum lines, which completely bypass the air filter and make the intake manifold look like this. So here's a clean finger. There's a dirty finger. That's what my motor's been breathing. Brand new motor. Brand new motor. Shot vacuum lines. Gummed up intake. And then on top of that, can't even use the proper bolts. And this, how expensive are bolts? We're buying a brand new motor and you can't put in the correct bolts. These things are cheap. And now I'm out here in the freezing cold trying to get this daggone gasket off and put a new one on. Let me show you what a good gasket looks like. And of course, this is brand new, obviously. So, you know, even if the gasket was done right, it's going to get a little dirty because that's where all your exhaust fumes are going. But this is what a brand new gasket looks like. So you've got this rubbery paper seal on the backside, and then you got the metal on the front side. All right. And it goes like this. So we paid to have a brand new gasket put on when we put in the brand new motor, brand new exhaust manifold, whole nine yards, and they skimp on bolts, and they skimp on vacuum lines. It's the little things, guys. It's the little things. Not only, and this isn't the only thing that we've had issues with from this company that installed the motor and transmission. When they installed the motor and transmission, either Jasper or All-Pro Tune forgot to pull the retaining pin out of the auto tensioner for the timing chain. So as your motor begins to break in, there's a timing chain in there with an auto tensioner on it, spring loaded, because this chain will begin to stretch over time. So this auto tensioner keeps that chain tight. Well, nobody pulled that pin from the factory to make sure that that spring could do its job and keep that chain tight. So we start getting this horrible racket, horrible sound. So either Jasper didn't pull the pin or All-Pro Tune didn't pull the pin when they installed it. Either which way, that had to go back and be redone. Covered underneath warranty, but time and money. Also, brand new motor, when it was installed, we had a rear main seal oil leak. How does that happen on a brand new motor? Well, I asked around, and apparently there is a shipping plug or a shipping seal on the rear main output shaft for the motor, where it goes into the bell housing, yada yada. Well, and I'll have to do some more research on this, but apparently they didn't pull out that shipping seal and put in the actual rear main seal. They just installed the transmission behind it. So we start leaking oil out of the back. Bad. Well, gotta go back to All-Pro Tune again so that they can take out the shipping seal and put in the actual rear main seal. So, then The day that I picked this thing up after the new motor, new transmission was installed, I barely get home. It's like a 20, 25 minute drive, not that far, maybe 15 to 20 minute drive. I barely make it home because I can't get the transmission to go in and out of gear. It's a manual transmission. Can't get the transmission to go in and out of gear. They said that somehow the pilot bearing broke the flywheel or the pressure plate or whatever. So that got screwed up. Now, they bought a whole new pressure plate, and I appreciate that. But that's another problem. They had to come tow the vehicle. I couldn't even drive it back for them to work on it.
Had to tow the vehicle back so they could redo this
throwout bearing or whatever, pilot bearing, whatever, that screwed up the pressure plate.
So there's that one. Not to mention that we are supposedly on our third transmission.
First transmission they install, I get maybe 1,000 miles on it, Jasper transmission,
and it's whining horribly, horribly bad.
So I take it back to All Pro Tune. They hook a stethoscope up to it. We drive like maybe 15 feet. He's like, nope, shut it down. He's like, obviously we need to do a warranty on that transmission. And they did do a warranty on the transmission, supposedly. So it goes back to All Pro Tune again. They pull that transmission out, put another transmission in. All right, so we're going down the road. Everything's hunky-dory and fine. Well, I'm overseas, and my wife calls me. She said, hey, I almost wrecked the Jeep. I'm okay, but there was a horrible racket all of a sudden. I was going down Highway 90. Everything was hunky-dory. And then all of a sudden, there's this horrible racket. The wheels lock up for a brief second, and then they start spinning again like normal. But there's this horrible racket. I can't get it in and out of gear hardly. I mean, the vehicle is just falling apart around me. I pull it off to the side of the road by the grace of God, and I just turn the damn thing off. My dad came and got my wife. At that point in time,
we took it to Hux Performance in Foley.
And my technician, James, over there that I know,
began to diagnose the problem. Now, Hux Performance is also a Jasper certified installer for motors and transmissions.
So we went ahead and sent it to Hux Performance because they were the closest.
He takes the transmission down
and finds out that the top bolt in the bell housing
that holds the transmission to the bell housing, one of those bolts fell off down into the bell housing where that flywheel is and the clutch and the input shaft and all that stuff, and basically grenaded, completely blew out the whole transmission. Yes, a bolt fell out of the top of the bell housing down into the flywheel and the input shaft for the transmission and just completely blew the whole transmission out, going about 60, 65 miles an hour down Highway 90 with my wife in it. A testament to her driving skills because she didn't flip the Jeep. You can almost look at a Jeep and it'll flip over in the yard like a dog that wants its belly scratched. But somehow she kept it upright. So my tech finds this chewed up bolt down at the bottom of the bell housing. And that's what basically grenaded the whole thing. So we call Jasper, and Jasper determines, along with the tech at Hux Performance, that it's not a warranty issue, it's a bad install issue.
So now we have to call All Pro Tune again and say, hey, look, you screwed up on the install for the transmission. You didn't use any Loctite on the bolts that hold the transmission to the bell housing. And you didn't use any lock washers. Not only that, but the bolt that fell out was cross-threaded and ran in with an impact wrench. And it was only a matter of time before it'd wiggle out and fall down and grenade the whole show. So now we're on our third, supposedly, transmission.
Third transmission.
Now, you could say that I'm just a grumpy customer and nothing can be done right. But here's the thing. I really don't know my left nut from a lug nut, okay? But they have these things called
repair manuals. And they also have these things that they have this thing called the internet and Jeep forums
and YouTube. And between the repair manual, a lot of note-taking,
a lot of research,
and YouTube videos and Jeep forums, you can pretty much figure out what you need to do. It's Army stupid simple. If you can read, follow instructions, and take guidance, you can get the job done. Just like reading an Army manual. It's that simple. So, I just don't understand how me, a really not ASE certified mechanic by any means, how I'm able to go through here and determine these problems, which are pretty clear. That's where the seal went. That's where the bad bolts were. Bad vacuum lines. Gunked up intake manifold. So, it just blows my mind that we pay money to have a brand new motor and brand new transmission installed, and people just don't give a crap, and they just chuck stuff in here. And it's not like this is a very complicated vehicle. It's a Jeep Wrangler. It's an old Jeep Wrangler. It's not like this is a Lexus ISF or an Infiniti or a Mercedes C-Class or what, or BMW or whatever. It's a very simple vehicle to work on. So I'm having difficulty understanding how so many things are just screwed up. Like I said, I might just be a grumpy person or a grumpy customer, but wrong bolts on the exhaust manifold, blown exhaust manifold gasket, shot vacuum lines, gummed up intake manifold, improper installation on the transmission. Bolt falls down in the transmission, grenades, completely blows the transmission, and my wife almost wrecks the Jeep in the process. Pin forgot to be pulled. Had to go back and have that done. Rear main seal leaking. Had to go back and had that redone. Now, I've taken this Jeep to other shops, and I've had no issues. Dave at Trailhead Jeeps did the lift kit on this Jeep. Haven't had one single problem. He completely re-engineered the steering. All of this. Check this out. Dave at Trailhead Jeeps completely built this whole entire steering system because I went to spring over axle. Stock Jeeps come with the axle over top of the spring. So he did the springs. He did the rewelding on the axles. He completely re-engineered the steering. Have not had one single problem with it. The guy that redid these axles re-geared them to 488 gears. From 410 to 488 gears. Haven't had a single problem out of these axles. No leaks, no whines, no roars, no nothing. Paid somebody to do the job. They did the job right. Once, the first time, done. James at Hux Performance fixed the transmission. Reinstalled a new one. But not only did he do that, he also saw that the exhaust muffler was not welded to the exhaust pipe going up to the motor. So guess what he did? He took the initiative and re-welded properly the exhaust pipe. Didn't even tell me about it. I had to find out one weekend while drinking a beer with him that he did this on his own. Another thing, while he's up underneath here, putting the new transmission in from Jasper that All-Pro Tune screwed up the installation on, he comes over here and he takes all these old vacuum lines and wires and stuff like this. You know, they still go to, you know, important things. But what does he do? He zip ties them up nice and neat, brand new zip ties, gets them all up out of the way to where they're not hanging on the muffler. We get my Jeep back from All Pro Tune, and one of the wires got cooked because it was laying on the exhaust pipe. I had to go fix that for free. Luckily, I had some extra wire in my shed, but you know, I just fixed that on my own. But that's ultimately what happened. So it's little things like this: bolts, vacuum lines, zip ties, making sure things are up and out of the way that they should be.
doing me a solid on the exhaust pipe back there. Welded it up right.
Wouldn't take money for it. He just said, hey, I was there. I just went ahead and did it. Now, I'm not asking for free stuff, but it's just, you know, take pride in your work. This is what, you know, I'm sure there's a clamp that it should be connected to, but you know, the vehicle's from 1995, but still. You know, he took the extra time to clamp this upright, to keep it out of the way, to where it doesn't overheat on this and melt. Took the time to weld the exhaust pipe up. He's putting in a transmission, not doing a muffler job.
But he went ahead and, you know, welded it up nice. Get a good seal. This whole thing was about ready to fall out.
So, and another thing, not only did the transmission blow when that bolt fell down, it took out the transfer case, too.
Now, granted,
my transfer case had 217,000 miles on it when that bolt took out the transmission. But before that happened, my transfer case was working. So, $1,500 to $1,600 later,
I've had to buy a whole new transfer case. Well, I'm going to have to buy a whole new transfer case. But James took extra parts that he had from a buddy of mine's Jeep and pretty much band-aided my transfer case back together to get me down the road until I could afford a proper transfer case. Didn't charge me for it.
So, there's some people that go the extra mile and take pride in their work. And then there's others that just clearly don't. They'd like to take shortcuts. Good work and good people are hard to find these days.
I will say that Gerald at All Protune is one of the nicest guys you will ever meet. Steve at All Protune is a solid dude. He'll do anything he can to help you out.
Really smart guy. And I'm sure that All Protune has a whole garage full of really good mechanics.
But there's at least one there that is obviously taking shortcuts.
On the transmission, on the vacuum lines,
on the motor install,
on the bolts. Cheap things, man. Really, really affordable things that make stuff last a lot longer.
So there's at least one mechanic there at All Protune who likes to take shortcuts. And it's making Gerald and Steve and All Protune look bad. And I won't take my vehicle back because I almost lost my wife due to a transmission blowing up at 60 miles an hour. It's a safety hazard. So I hope they keep their good technicians, get rid of the bad ones, but I don't have the confidence to take my vehicle back to that shop anymore. Hux Performance and James that works down there, absolutely. Any day of the week.
Dave at Trailhead Jeeps? Absolutely. Some of the best money I've ever spent.
Money well spent. But this is not what right looks like. Should not have to be replacing an exhaust manifold gasket right at about a year. So, thank you.